What's up, guys? Welcome to Car Audio Q&A. I'm Doug.
I'm Alan.
And I'm Spizzle McNizzle.
This is the show where we take your questions you ask on our forum, and we answer them, and then we go get a Slurpee afterwards.
Slurpee! Slurpee! Red Dot!
Do they still have Slurpees?
Yeah, they do.
You can slurp these.
Nuts.
Slurp on these nuts!
Yeah!
Enough of you.
Starting out like
Snuff
that.
Enough of you with a Slurpee
Starting
suit.
Out like that.
You started it.
Started.
You said Slurpee.
Just to let you guys know, Amplified and Car Audio Q&A is available on iTunes. So just type in...
iTunes.
Amplified or Car Audio, and you'll see it in the podcast section below. Buy some shirts. Subscribe. And help promote the shows. If you guys know guys that are interested in car audio, try to spread the word. We're trying to get these views up.
So we or even someone that just likes
Yeah, we don't have the same friends that you do on Facebook, even though like a lot of you guys we're friends with. So like if you can repost, I know we'll obviously see it, and that's cool. But a lot of your other friends will also see it, especially if they're into car audio. So we just kind of want to spread the word. And if you guys could help, that'd be awesome.
And we've been pretty stoked. CarAudioMag.com, Car Audio and Electronics Magazine. That's the website, right?
CarAudioMag.com. Yeah, it's CarAudioMag.com, yeah.
They've been plugging our shows every time we have a new one out. It's right there on their front page. So I want to say thanks to those guys. They've been hooking it up. There's another thing I wanted to... Oh, we're gonna launch an online store soon, like a full e-commerce site. We're not going to be selling a bunch of car audio stuff for dirt cheap, but we're going to hit all the specialty items that you do-it-yourselfers and pros need to do the job right. Some of the specialty iPad installation stuff, and we have a updated iPad how-to instructional video coming soon too. So, for you iPad guys, look forward to that.
All right, what's the first question?
First question is from Sam Liu. Interested to know which one you guys think has better SQ. Knowing.
Can we get someone that reads?
No, this guy typed it totally weird. I already read it.
It's not Spoon's fault.
No, it's not. Keep going.
How about you read them, and I should next time.
Read.
So you can be like, Anyways.
I just read the shit. Try to read it.
What do you think has better SQ, knowing that you guys hear them all the time? Or maybe the high energy? Also, is hybrid Ovation a lot better than Dotech Ovation? Is it worth... to spend that extra roughly $300 or so for the upgrade?
I'll take the Morel question. He can answer the other. But honestly, if you're going to go for Morel, the only ones that I would even consider looking at that I think are worth it are going to be the Elates or the Supremos.
Yep.
In my opinion, because I've worked with them, I've had all of them in my own car. When you get from like your Tempos to your Dotex to your Hybrid Ovation, there's... each one's a big jump, and there's not a huge difference in the way they sound. So the best bet, if you're looking for SQ and you're looking to just get the best speaker as far as like the Morel line, I would suggest the Elate. It wouldn't be worth spending an extra $300 because there's not a whole lot difference at all. The big jump is from their bottom of the line to the Elate. All the ones in between are kind of just, you know.
Oh, Elate's the one with the big, giant voice coil. That's the
3-inch voice coil.
That's huge difference. And you just saw the Elate. We just cut to it.
As far as the SQ, I'll let him answer that. Everyone's going to have their own little bit of a
SQ
different opinion.
SQ for what?
What speaker?
Outside of that.
No,
outside of that?
Yeah, because he also asked about high energy.
Look, high energy's good. If you're going into the Hertz stuff, I would look into the Mille. Some people...
Mille.
There's a little bit of debate.
What word am I trying to say?
Oh, he's trying to sneak up in my episode.
I think if you're from Italy,
the Mille.
It's going to be the Mille.
But the Mills are badass, dude. That's like where it gets really good for Hertz. And that's in the $900 to $1,000 price range. You know, for SQ stuff, that's probably what you're looking at. You know, another one to look at is Hybrid Audio Legatia series. Bitchin' ass stuff. Same price range. Those are kind of my top three right now. Morel Hybrid or the Hertz.
Yeah, if you look at that Car Audio Mag website that we actually mentioned earlier, if you go to click under reviews.
Yeah, they got good reviews.
They have a top 10 speakers of the last decade, and out of a total of 100 points, the Hertz Mille MLK 165s have been reviewed as the highest speaker out there at 87 points. Nothing else has touched it yet. There's obviously been newer speakers that have come out since then that haven't been reviewed, but that one's basically top dog. So anything else below, it's definitely going to be a step down, but still good.
That's all two-way kits.
Yep, those are all two-way.
What's the next one?
Next one is from Jimmy. I want to run a ported box, but my amp doesn't have a subsonic filter. Is there any inline subsonic filter thingy that I could use?
Depends on the woofer size. If you're doing a 12, you don't need a subsonic filter. Your amp is only going to put out the lowest frequency it's going to put out is 20K or 20 Hertz. So subsonic filter is more for cutting off the super low frequencies for a smaller woofer. At least that's my understanding, right?
Yeah, I'd agree.
I never use subsonic filters. Because ideally you want to do a sub that's going to drop to 20.
I mean, a lot of people say just to use one anyway, because, you know, don't stress the woofer out when it, you can't really, when it's not really efficient in that frequency range anyway. Yeah, you'll feel it, but you can't hear anything in that range anyway.
Yeah, but you want something to drop.
But if you're talking ported and you want loud and you want to be able to feel it, like, you're not going to want to cut it off at 30.
Big woofer that takes a ton of power, and don't skip on the power, you know? A lot of power, a lot of woofer. Fuck a subsonic filter.
And subsonic filter a lot of time is used when, like,
you don't have tipping on my dick.
Tipping on my dick. If you don't have an adequate box, if it's not the right box.
What is that? Have to do with anything.
Tipping on my dick.
You should just use a flux capacitor. You tip it on your dick.
Alright, next.
What is next?
Featured install.
Woo! Install or product?
Install.
So we did two questions and now it's install?
Correct.
Okay. This is from ProStatus09 on YouTube. That's his YouTube username. He sent me a video. But I took some stills. This is a 212W6 box. There's 212W6s. There's the beginning of it. Two slot ports. Look at that. Is it good?
You kind of got a glare. That's all right.
Yeah, you got the light up in there.
How's that?
There you go.
It's all right.
There's the construction. I like how he left a lip around the whole top and bottom.
Yeah, that's nice.
All reinforced. There's the upholstery. Looks like you did suede in the middle. Are you shaking the shit out of that camera or what?
No.
There it is, carpeted and upholstered. Is that double wall? Wow, that's double wall. That's a lot of work. And there it is.
It's a pretty nice box.
Yeah, I like it. I'd be stoked with that in my trunk. And that's the featured install of the day. ProStatus online on YouTube. Check out the video. The video is entitled JL. Oh, I cut the fucking thing off. JL Audio 2W. 12. JL Audio 12W6. Cool. There it is.
Wow.
Yeah, I like it. Good job, Pro Status.
What's the question? So next. Is that zoomed in? Next question is from Kyle Simmons. If I install a Bit One and some amps, how would I go about tuning them? Amps first, Bit One first,
That's all you. You're Mr. iPad Bit One. Boy.
You're Mr. Byte One. I mean, Bit One.
Byte One. To install your Byte One, well, to do it right, you're going to need an oscilloscope. And you're going to
shove it up your ass.
You gotta, dude. You gotta put the camera on yourself and say that.
And shove it up your ass.
Hey, what happened to your tube?
It's gone.
It's still gone. This fool. He had a temporary cap. He had a root canal, so they nubbed his tooth down, and then put a temporary on that shit, and it fell off, and it was all in amplified of this toothless motherfucker, and then, dude, he takes Zip Kick. Like, the glue, he didn't spray it with accelerate, but he puts fucking super glue in the tooth and glued his shit back in.
This one comes out of the bathroom. Ah, it's hot! This is supposed to be burning up!
Tripping, glued his tooth
He's asking if it's supposed to be burning like you're a fucking dentist.
That's normal. You know, every time I super glue a tooth in, it burns like that.
Spoons like, yeah, every time I do
that's
that.
That's crazy, dude.
Last time I glued a tooth in for a crackhead.
I told him to do it.
He's nuts, dude.
Alright.
So you kind of adjust the bit one, and then adjust your amp, and then go back and finish the bit one. Because you got to get the signal out of the bit one to where it doesn't clip. And you're measuring that with an oscilloscope. It'll show you the sound wave and show you if it's clipping. And then you go to your amp and you do the same thing. Adjust it to where the signal's not clipping. And you go back into the bit one. And then you set all your shit. So you probably do crossover points and gains on the bit one. And then you go do gains on the amp. And then you go back and EQ.
You're going to have to go back and forth many times. But and none of you are going to have an oscilloscope. So... But built into the Bit One software when you plug into your laptop.
To mean, man?
I'm just saying.
And built into the Bit One software.
It does show each channel, and it does show what channel is clipping. Yeah. So that can help you adjust everything on the Bit One. But you do want to set up the Bit One, then go to the amps, and then go back. It's not something you're going to get done in 10 minutes. It's going to be something.
And actually, there's another part of that. You got to, the source that's going into the Bit One, got to get that. The volume up as high as it'll go before it clips. Then goes the bit one, get that as high as you can go before that clips. Then you go to the amp, get that as high as it can go before it clips. And then go in, throw your RTA in the car, EQ it, and then time delay it. And then you're going to time, if you're doing an active setup, you obviously want to time delay each one separately. That's a whole other.
You motherfucker.
You motherfucker!
It was delayed.
Oh, time delayed. I get it.
What's the next question? Stupid. Next question is from Russell.
Nay! We are the naysayers.
Anyways, I'm seriously considering installing a 3G iPad. I can't work under these conditions. Telling you.
Alright, I need another beer.
A beer.
Come on, man!
Okay. Seriously considering installing a 3G iPad into my Cayenne S08.
That's Porsche, for those of you that don't know.
Is it possible? And he's concerned about sound quality.
iPad, sound quality in the iPad is really good, I would say. I would say it's just as good, if not better, than any head unit out there. And it is possible. There's some intense fabrication. You're going to have to move some stuff around on your dash. But I'll do it. Ship me your car. I'll slap an iPad right in your Porsche. Anything you'd like to add to that?
I'll slap my iPad and you're...
No.
You're not big on the whole iPad thing.
I'm not.
It's because he doesn't have one.
He's always been kind of a softy, though.
Softy?
Yeah.
About what?
You're keeping your stock deck and your car. And
I don't want to cut anything.
I mean, would you take a Cayenne or a Porsche S or whatever and... cut the shit out of the dash?
Hell yeah!
That would be the most fucking stupid thing you could do.
Oh wait, that would be sick.
That would be fucking stupid.
That means you gangster. That's how real pimps
roll.
Well,
he doesn't know what it's like to have an iPad in the dash.
I wouldn't want an iPad in my dash.
Alright, well, to each his own.
Keep
your stock deck with your outdated nav.
What's the next one? Whatever.
Future products.
I'm just going to put a Sony head unit in, like Spoon.
Dude.
I'm going to do an iPad if you have my Sony.
Yeah!
I've been waiting. I couldn't wait till you said that.
Instead of you giving me a Sony, now I'll give you an outdated Sony.
This is our featured product for this episode. This just came out from JL Audio. It's a C5 three-way setup. It's pretty nice, dude. I can't wait to try them. We got these. I'm going to show an install, so it'll be probably an amplified.
I think we're the only people that have those, aren't we?
No, they've been out for a little while.
It should go in my car.
They're really new. John wants to put them in his car. Hey, come over here, John. We'll open this up.
Yeah, John, let's talk about it.
Yeah, come on, John. So 3-inch mid.
That looks like a 4.
I think it's a 3, dude.
You sure?
Yeah.
Looks like a 4-inch. I think it's a 4.
Comes with a nice grill. How's this supposed to work?
What do you mean, how this supposed to work?
Look, the little ears are bigger than the grill, bro. What is this?
Oh, these are some Imby Cork grills.
Oh, snap. You could take...
My favorite part's the crossover. They're blue. It's the best color. Los Angeles.
So it's about the color.
Los Angeles.
And you wouldn't like it if it was black?
Mm-mm. Oh, so this is cool, though. Because you could take these ears off. Hey, would you hold that shit still? You could take the ears off. This... Dude, you're trying to film this and you're
giggling like a schoolgirl. Why are you laughing so hard for? Toothless motherfucker. Why are you trying to laugh so hard for?
I'm not.
Why are you laughing so hard?
His face is red. His face is red.
Alright, I'm getting serious. Alright.
So you can take these ears off.
Yes.
What the fuck? It's because you can take the ears off? You're laughing like that?
Alright. Jeez.
So you could take these things off and clamp it on like that. So you have a nice all black if you want to expose it. Or you could put this in there. How is it supposed to work? You can take that off.
Yeah, and then that goes on.
That's because this is cool for a factory location that the screw holes line up. And then you take them off and then this goes in.
Yeah, it's a sandwich.
That's cool though, because you can go without the grill though, yeah, if you want to do this.
It's a C5 sandwich.
Yeah, that would like, anyway, pretty cool without this grill.
A C5 sandwich. Let's pack that up. Pack that up.
Yeah, you gotta see the crossovers.
Comes with some cool little jail audio things for your mids.
I need one of those for my hat.
But it's cool because it's really like uniform looking. So here's your 6.5 spot for the grill, so it looks nice and uniform. There's the mid. C5 mid. This stuff's all designed in Germany, right?
It's made in Germany.
Designed and made? Oh, no, it's designed here.
Yeah, it's designed in Florida.
Assembled in Germany.
Yep. Oh. Yeah, these are like your better of the JL speakers. They're, I mean, not the, you know, a lot of other stuff's made in China also from other brands, but for your better built German engineered speaker, although, you know, JL Audio designed the speaker, this is definitely a much nicer speaker in their line.
These are supposed to be bomb, dude. I've heard a lot of good things about these. I'll try them for myself and let you know. They look really good. The C5 sound pretty good that I've messed with the regular two-ways.
Crossover.
Yeah, so if you're looking at an all JL setup, see, you're gonna not want to go with anything except
so
C5.
Sick.
Yeah, that's pretty nice.
That's what I wanted to show in my car.
You see?
Through the panel.
This is the first time I've seen this.
This is badass.
It's actually a pretty impressive network, dude.
Yeah, that's nice.
It's actually really
it's
nice.
Legit.
Look at it, it's got the USA colors, bro. Red, white, and blue.
It is red, white, and blue.
That's what I
said. It is!
It is.
That's why I like it. Come on, you
guys. There's a lot of black in there, too.
I don't like black.
A lot of black in the USA. Okay, go
that's
back
cool,
over.
That's cool, because you got screen. Jumpers on the mid,
yep.
And the tweeter.
Yeah, I was kind of wishing I had those the other day in the car.
This shit's going in my car, dude.
Well, you're going to have to step up your install, boy, because this shit can't take a year.
You know what we should do?
You just have to be in the car soon.
Okay, if we don't put these in John's.
Yeah, I'm here. I'm listening.
Why don't we raffle them off?
Ooh. Raffle. Well, what do you guys think about raffling off some C5 three-ways? I know what I'm going to hear on that.
Yeah. After we've tested them out and done a review on them, I think we should raffle them off.
We'll talk about that.
Quarrel.
All
right, ready for next
We'll talk about raffling. You know, we might go in my car.
Well, let us know what you think.
About a raffle. You know what they're going to think.
Put it in what? John's car, that's what they're going to be thinking.
Yeah, either put them in John's car or give them to you.
What do you mean? What do you think they're going to think?
They're going to fucking raffle that. You want to raffle that shit, dude? It's bomb.
What's wrong with a raffle?
Damn. $700 pair of speakers raffle.
I'm going to sneak in that box and write John on every single ticket. So don't be fucking around.
All right, what's the next question?
Next question is
$700 for breakfast.
Did you say Sterling Warren?
No, I said...
Why are you trying to always sneak up in my episodes?
I said Sam Mino.
Oh.
my bad.
Hey, can you guys make a video on how to set up a test bench like the one you have in your shop? I want to set up something like that so I could test amps and speakers before installation.
What do we have on that thing? We just have a deck?
We have a deck, we have a power supply, and we made a cool little panel which you can hook up speakers to test.
Yeah, so the
cigarette
on the
lighter,
on the panel. On the panel it goes
speaker in, speaker out.
Speaker wires out of the deck to the panel, and then it has terminal cups that jump out and go into the speakers that are around the shop. So you could take them out, test the speaker on it, and then you could put an amp into it to connect it to the speaker. It has RCAs for input, so you go auxiliary on the deck, and you could test the output of a radio.
Audio and video.
Audio and video, and we got a screen and shit. I don't know if you need to do all that, though. But it's kind of nice to be able to test, because we have a DVD player and a screen, so we could test someone's DVD player and their screen. We have RCAs that loop audio, video RCAs in and out.
And a cigarette lighter plug.
And a cigarette lighter plug, gotta have that.
I think if you just show like a still, or maybe slowly just show what we have in there, then people will understand. Because we have them all labeled.
I'd recommend a big battery, too.
We don't even have a battery.
I know, we don't have one. Yeah, we need one, though, dude. But if you really want to, like, pound on an amp and test it out and actually pound put a load on it.
He wants to
pound on it, yeah.
He said he wants to pound on an amp and put a load on it.
Sounds like summertime barbecue.
I've caught Spoon putting his little dick in the RCA holes before, all right?
Come on! It's a family show here.
Hey, what? It's nice.
It feels good, huh? Oh, what's the next question? That shit just went south.
Did you hear him?
He said, no, I won't. Good. No more level.
And if you do it fast enough, you get engine wide.
Oh, the tweaker.
Okay. Squealy ass pig.
Wow. Geeky, wow.
Geeky. Okay, last question is from Jean Phillips.
Jean Philippe?
Eh? Jean Philippe Hossen.
Anybody remember Optimus subs from Radio Shack? You know what, John?
Don't even ask that question.
I remember.
I don't even know what to say because I don't even want to read the rest of it.
Read the whole thing. I got to hear this.
Alright, anybody remember Optimus subs from Radio Shack? Boy, they were the shit. I ran two of them shits on my old Jensen amp and had it be hitting 125 dB easy.
That's a black redneck from Kentucky. Kentucky, she was two from Kentucky too.
Kentucky two?
Have you ever seen
those? I heard a lot. Remember Dan Kirchenberg used to talk about those Optimus?
Yeah.
I guess it must have bumped, dude.
Optimus.
That's what I said.
Oh, Optimus Prime?
Optimus Prime. Yeah, that's what Optimus Prime has, dude, in the truck. No, but like, you can make a cheap ass woofer sound good if you build the right box and put a grip of power on it.
Just don't buy it from me.
You know, it's not the sub itself. I think Optimus probably must have been a decent design because I've heard that more than once. You know what I'm saying?
No, oh, I'm sure.
Would you run Optimus in your car?
No.
Me either. But that's just a funny question.
If it's a prime Optimus.
That's like some old school shit, dude. People running Optimus woofers. What do they have at Radio Shack? Didn't they have like some COS woofers or some shit?
COS headphones.
Yeah, get some COS headphones with an amplifier in my deck.
I had a guy come in here once and he was like, I need a job, man. I'm like, well, what can you do? He's like, dude, I can make Radio Shack shit sound good. And I was like, shit doesn't mean you get a job because you can make Radio Shack shit sound good. Like,
remember the drunk guy that you gave him a test?
Yeah, dude, this guy was like, I want a job. And he kept going and he's like, I know everything. He's like, you can test me on something. And if I fail the test, then I'll walk away.
He was drunk?
I think so.
Yeah, he was lit.
So I'm like, all right, how do you wire up reverse polarity door locks? He's like,
on two relays.
And I'm like, I'll draw the fucking relays on a paper for you. I drew them, labeled the prongs, and I'm like, there you go. And he sat, dude, for an hour and a half.
Yeah, he said, it's impossible to do it with two relays. You can only do it with one.
And then he comes to me, he's like, I got it. I'm like, what? That was a trick question. I'm like, that's not a trick question, dude. Come on, get the fuck out of here.
He said, you can't do reverse polarity with two relays. You can only do it with one.
Is he in frame?
No.
Wow.
Dumbass.
Wow.
Queer.
Out of frame.
Queer bar.
All right, what else? What are we trying to promote?
The hell's a gay bar.
What else we got going on?
I think just promote the show on Facebook.
Me.
Just do it.
Me. Promote me. Everyone loves Spoon. Spoon.
We're your after hours.
Spoon on almost every comment.
Yeah, it's been doing pretty good, though. Our fans have been going up.
John.
But we need him to go higher.
It's just a lot of work.
R-A-H-I-N.
And I want to keep doing it, so that means I need money.
A lot of time for you guys.
Bahim.
Taking out of our own time.
Bahim sheem in a deem deem.
This fool's yelling over here. You done yelling?
Yeller!
We're trying to get people to add us on Facebook.
That's it, dude. Right?
No, there's got to be something else. This is just too short. No,
too short?
No, that's got to be it.
That's all?
My top down.
Well, you can sit here and keep filming. I'm going home.
Yeah, seriously. I need to go gym it up. I just took my steroids.
Oh, we got a few things for sale.
I'm trying to fart in Alan's face. Ooh, it's all warm.
Wow.
What are you going to sell Sony hats for?
We got a stack of Sony hats that we got for free.
And we're going to sell them to you.
That's fucked up.
If you would like one,
hey,
they're $10.
Sony hat giveaway, dude.
They're $10 and $5 for shipping. It's $15. It's a good deal.
All right. Sony hats. There's 5 Sony hats. To win a Sony hat, we're going to pick 5 people out of the people that do the best impersonation of Alan.
You know what Sony stands for, right?
Or pictures of your girlfriend's big old boobies.
Suck on nipples.
Impersonation of
me. No, how about him? He's a goofy bastard.
Yeah.
All right, you got to do an impersonation video of John. Post that shit up on YouTube.
Or me.
And then
the
5 best ones.
Tattoos.
We'll get some Sony hats.
Oh, we should do look-alike contest, too.
You know look-alike contest.
Hey, but you know what Sony stands for, right?
What?
Suck on...